This presentation is about discrete event simulation and its role in integrated factory modeling. I'm Mike Joliker. I'm the director of the Autodesk relationship at ProModel, which is a division of Big Bear AI. So this is designed to be a 90-minute class, but it's not going to run nearly that long. But here's the things that we hope to cover in that amount of time. So thing one is to understand the benefits of discrete event simulation for manufacturing and architectural engineering and construction customers. We want to see how a return on investment can be developed from the data gathered. We want to be able to provide strong business metrics to support business cases. That includes cost and also time savings. And also we want to provide 2D and 3D animated process models utilizing AutoCAD, Inventor, and Forge with one button click. So Autodesk tools provide a great foundation for building a digital twin in familiar tools that you're probably already using for layout today. ProModel provides the ability to turn your CAD layout documentation into a powerful tool for throughput simulation, helping customers get the best return on investment for their process changes and in turn, reducing the cost of the manufacturing of their products. The Autodesk toolset provided in Product Design and Manufacturing Suite does a great job of streamlining the layout process for space claim. The factory design utilities make it easy to transition 3D and reap the benefits it provides, but the toolset lacks in regards to process planning. And that's where ProModel enters the picture. So we provide the ability to test and evaluate design ideas and follow and allow users to make the best decisions based on their criteria for success. And this all occurs right inside of the AutoCAD that they're already using today for spatial layout. So in every project, large or small, there are three contributors to the design. Technical building equipment represents the connective tissue, if you will, between the building and the production line. The building design may represent either a new greenfield site, which is a brand new building, or more commonly seen today is retrofitting of an existing site or brownfield workflow. Or it could be a combination of both of these. So though these are hugely important in regards to a successful installation of a new production area, this is not really the focus of our topic today. We are focused today on the production planning leg of this workflow. So spatial consideration is most important, but equally important, if not more important, is the performance of the process, being that it is right-sized for our production goals, that it delivers the correct amount of products at the lowest costs, and that it is agile in nature. So this allows for new products to be added without upsetting the balance of what is currently being produced. So again, these are things that are very difficult to predict, and software like ProModel will help us be able to predict that. So a valuable tool for validation, discrete event simulation, is really nothing new. It's been around in one form or another since Henry Ford rolled the first Model T off of the line. In fact, ProModel has been delivering PC-based simulation solutions for over 30 years to thousands of customers worldwide. And these customers could be from the smallest job shop to the largest production high-volume manufacturer. Discrete event simulation inside of AutoCAD, however, is new. The ProModel consulting team will tell you that over 90% of projects they deliver start with an AutoCAD layout. And in fact, we know that almost every customer that's out there that is doing layout work is probably doing it. If they're doing it in CAD, they're probably using AutoCAD. A lot of effort had to be expended to utilize an AutoCAD drawing in the ProModel environment. And really, it worked that way for any other discrete event tool that's out there. For that reason, ProModel and Autodesk teamed up to provide a really easy to use, efficient tool set that runs inside of the AutoCAD environment that you use today for layout. This new tool set helps build the foundation of the integrated factory model that is much more than a drawing that represents space claim. The CAD model now becomes a powerful enterprise decision-making tool. So what exactly is process simulation and what does it do? So it's a digital environment experimentation tool for validating ideas and for improving process, either in existing production situations or completely new design ideas. So this allows us to have no risk experimentation with process design ideas inside of the AutoCAD you're already using. It's an easy to understand environment that ties your CAD layout to process timing data and allows design idea iteration to get to the best answer. So the data is really kind of the yin and yang of the process design. So if throughput can be achieved, but it won't fit into the space allotted, that's no good. And if the layout fits great into the allotted space, but it can't deliver the required products in the specified amount of time, that's kind of useless also. So you really need both sides of the coin to be successful here. So ProModel also provides time-based systems analysis. It mimics the operations of the existing or future process for that purpose of understanding and improving that system. This also allows the ability to compress time. That is, we can simulate a year's worth of production in minutes and be able to see where the problems are. Many times, production issues in regards to throughput do not reveal themselves right away. And it can be challenging to find without these tools, as there are many interdependencies to track, which ProModel excels at. So this is the basic simulation methodology that we follow. We also consider the real world factors in here. So for example, we need the variability in task times. We can also account for variability and average this over multiple runs of a line to get the most accurate representation, right? So what we do is we can take that, the simulation that we're running, we build variability into each one of the processes, we run it several times, as many times as you want to run it, and then we generate an average from that. So this will allow us to be even more accurate in our findings. We also track interdependent events. This is where we can find and identify where the bottlenecks occur and figure out what's really causing them. And then also resource availability, which is a major contributor to process problems. And it's nearly impossible to determine using tools like spreadsheets, mainly because spreadsheets do not understand the concepts of time. So it's easily understood in this environment. And then we look at things like calendar factors, things like holidays, shift changes, planned and unplanned downtime, which can all be factored in, as well as things like maintenance timing studies and manpower needs can also be studied. So broken down, there are three steps we follow for analysis. The first thing we do is visualize. So we do diagramming, modeling, and reporting. We visualize your process flow with on-screen process animation. So within the AutoCAD environment, we can see processes run based on the criteria we set. So conveyor system bottlenecks, process choke points, and spatial problems are identified right in the AutoCAD environment that the user is using to create their layout. Then we analyze. From here, we can get configurable dashboards that allow us to measure against KPIs we deem most important, be that takt time, part cost, or labor and resource utilization, or all of the above. The chart tools are directly tied to the model, so as the design ideas are explored, the data dashboard updates as well. We are then able to optimize. From the data provided by analysis, we can now experiment with the process via scenarios, more or less pulling levers in the model to see how it behaves with different criteria applied to that model. The dashboards allow us to then compare the scenarios against each other and help implement the best case that will offer the correct throughput at the best cost. So the tools in the factory design utilities excel in helping customers avoid excessive cost and risks in changeover. That is, making sure everything will physically fit into the space allotted and that the equipment interfaces physically as well. So this helps avoid change orders on installation, which can drive project costs up substantially. What it does not allow for is for planners to see how this plan change will affect the cost of the products being manufactured, or the ability to confirm that the design will meet the required throughput to meet demand, both current and future. That's where Pro Model comes in. So we allow those that plan change, be it for new products or process improvement or automation, or bringing acquired companies into the corporate fold, to fully understand if the process that is being developed will meet the production needs and be cost effective, either lowering the cost of manufacturing or allowing more manufacturing agility. The combination of these tool sets allow customers to build out a facility's digital twin that can be used over and over again to test ideas before committing any capital or hiring any people. The Autodesk Pro Model solution in combination reduces cost and risk not only for installation of the new process, but operational risks for producing the product throughput and throughout its life cycle. Here's a brief overview of the user interface. So it's a straightforward, easy to navigate interface that AutoCAD users will find very easy to learn and master. And the experienced users, people that do a lot of work in industrial engineering, will be able to apply macros, logic, and other advanced tools to easily further refine simulation outcomes. Those that have used Inventor or are using tools like iLogic will take to this workflow like a duck to water, very easy to learn and easy to understand. Those that also work in Visual Basic would find this easy to use. So we can extend the basic capabilities of the product to be able to suit exactly what you need it to do. So this all comes under a tab that's added to the AutoCAD ribbon, and this contains all of the command structure necessary to create simulations. There's also browser panels that can be accessed from the ribbon. So they provide detailed information and interactive feedback in regards to the simulation being studied. So let's start off looking at the products in action. Our first example is a validation of an engine assembly line for a four-cylinder engine. Our criteria for success is listed here. We need an average throughput to be able to be met. But in addition, we need to be able to meet determined spikes or demand spikes as required. Furthermore, we need to make sure that this fits into the space allotted and understand how the feeder products get to the line. So this represents the intended flow of the line, and the timing and numbers are based on past experience. So in other words, we've done a line like this before. We kind of have a feel for what it's going to be, so we'll just put those numbers in based on what we had in the past. But note also that each of these numbers and times are deterministic. That is, they have an absolute number in them. So they're 45 seconds, 130 seconds, 72 seconds. As humans are doing this work, the chances of repeatability of that timing is pretty low, if not impossible. So that's why ProModel allows users to include process time variability into the model, which increases accuracy and predictability. And we find that if we build a model based on the existing flow that a customer gives us, we are typically within 5% of what the customer is seeing in the real world. And we're usually a lot more accurate than however they were trying to predict it using a spreadsheet or so on. In fact, not usually, we always are. So let's run through the demonstration. So as shown here, the AutoCAD layout can now be used to analyze our manufacturing design idea. So the browser interface reflects the flow of product through the line as seen here. And we can see live how products will flow through this line. So this is going to help designers complete tasks like right-sizing the line-side AGV robots, as well as to see where a potential bottleneck may be. So we can also gain a better understanding on how workers are traveling and help remove non-value added work and travel, as well as making sure that we're properly staffed on this line. So because we are using AutoCAD as the base and the CAD drawing is to scale, we can get distance travel for a part or the material handling or for workers, which are linked to the model, which means that if we change the drawing, the distances update accordingly, which will reduce chance for costly errors in the future. And then we can apply scenarios, which have different speeds and settings for the line, and we can see what works best for our needs. So conveyor speeds, process speeds, manpower and staffing, all of these can be tested in the scenario manager. From here, we not only get dashboard output, but we get the ability to show the simulation in 3D. By clicking of one button, the factory design utilities open in Inventor, the 3D representation is generated, making it easier to communicate our design intent with others. The model can also be animated in 3D using ProModel's 3D Simulation Viewer. Literally one button click, and this is the easiest in the industry. So using the CAD visuals and the configurable output viewer, we can see where the problem lies. And in this case, it's the station where the heads are bolted onto the engine. So panning and zooming and rotating the view while running are all supported in the viewer, allowing us to focus in as required. So current design has the operator torquing each bolt separately, which is time consuming, not to mention error prone. So we're proposing that we add a multi-spindle digital torque nut runner to the system, reducing line cycle time and the chance for errors. But there's an offset to that. This piece of equipment is around $250,000 US, and we're going to have to justify that. So from there, we can use scenarios in the output viewer and make it even simpler for the non-CAD-oriented personnel to experience the different configurations. So the output viewer lets us clearly see the problem areas using magenta, green, and yellow to represent different states. And also, the throughput tab allows us to be to see that we're able to produce 12 more engines in two shifts, which is a good thing. So as we can see, we're able to validate the space claim in 2D and 3D and validate that our line will produce more engines per shift, yielding 12 more engines per day based on the data that we input into the simulation if we are to add the nut runner to the line. We see it as $984 profit per engine, and that's what our projected profit is. So we can take that number and apply that against the cost of the proposed change to add the nut runner, which is $245,000. From that, we can develop an ROI. So based on this, we can extrapolate an ROI of 20 days that gives us confidence that the investment made in the equipment will pay back and pay back quickly. Moreover, we can reuse the simulation over and over again to test for different scenarios, process changes, or new processes based on this process. Or we can add more criteria to further refine the process, or look at the process running over 16 months, for example, and see what the benefit of overtime is, including things like shifts and downtime and manpower constraints. We can try other criteria as well based on the findings that the simulation provides. And this is all in an environment that allows us to test these ideas before committing any capital, and furthermore, allows us to be able to update all of the CAD data immediately based on the findings that we have, and everything is linked together. Let's look at another example. This is a process retrofit that we've been trying to accomplish for over 30 years, but we always run into a roadblock when we reveal the price tag to make the change. So sustainability is becoming more critical and becoming a more discussed part of business decision making. And this is, you know, partially due to the cost of energy as well as being better to the planet. So in this case, we'll use this to our advantage to sell this product to upper management and to the financial controller. So in this example, we have a customer that's been using a 1940s developed manufacturing process, reliant on old technology machine tools that take a long time to change over, and natural gas-fired heat treating processes, which consume a lot of natural gas and output a lot of carbon dioxide. In addition, a substantial amount of space is required for these ovens because they're large, and it, of course, needs to be climate controlled inside of that building. And it needs to be electrically powered as well as maintained. So there's a lot of things that happen with that building, and there's a lot of advantages for not having that space. In fact, as we know, floor space by square foot is very expensive, and we're trying to reduce the amount of floor space that we need to produce our parts. So also in consideration is the changeover time. So when we originally commissioned this line, there was a 4-hour changeover time that was put in for these analog machines, for the bar feeders. And this was acceptable as we only had 6 product variants. So natural gas was also inexpensive to provide fuel for the ovens that have to run at 1,500 degrees Fahrenheit 24/7, or otherwise we risk damage to the fire brick linings inside of the ovens, and they're very expensive to repair. So these things have to run 24/7. And of course, the financial controller says, you know, once we tell them, hey, this is going to cost us some money to change this over, he says what he said for the past 30 years. Hey, you know what? It works. The machines are long paid for. Let's just keep doing it for another year. Well, the problem is, in today's production, we now have over 80 different variants of that part, not six. So to offset changeover time, we manufacture extras of each of these parts, which becomes inventory that we have to put in a warehouse someplace. And this increases costs and promotes waste, both in space and old inventory that may or may not ever be used, or may not be used for several years. We don't know. So by using modern tool sets, we can use both spatial data and throughput data to our advantage. And in this case, factor how energy costs can not only help us make the parts at higher quality and lower cost, but reduce the carbon footprint, which may help improve the bottom line for us through things like tax incentives for green initiatives. So we can also further reduce risk by using 3D layouts to ensure seamless installation and commission of the line. So let's have a look at the tool in action. Here we have the representation of the current space. These are analog screw machines and older three-axis machines and gas-fired heat treating processes that require their own building due to safety and also require an automated guided vehicle to haul parts back and forth for production process. So as earlier stated, these screw machines are not CNC. They're difficult to load and maintain, and they take a long time to set up. And our design requires us to change only part of this line, not all of it, the beginning portion of the process, and eliminate the need for gas-fired heat treating ovens. We're going to go to an induction heating workflow. So in the same drawing, we can have the representation of the proposed process. So we can tell ProModel to compare these two scenarios against each other. In this case, the current state, which is our baseline, and our proposed future state. And it's understood that a fairly sizable investment needs to be committed to modernize. And our goal is to show that the cost is justified. So we can start the simulation. We can see both systems running their parts based on the schedule that we provided. And we're also tracking the energy consumption on each machine and comparing the baseline against the proposed state. In addition, we can see the simulation running in 3D or the integrated factory model. So if the building, and you'll also notice too, the building that's on here is represented by a Revit model that was done by our building contractor. And this is linked into the model. So if the building changes, we see the update automatically to our 3D model as well as 2D model. So this prevents collision issues when building or MEP changes are made, which if not caught can put the current installation schedule at risk. And we can also see the current and proposed models are displayed and run in 3D, better, allowing us to better communicate our design intent. So again, this is all part of the integrated factory model. We not only have the physical machines and what we're looking at changing, but we also have the throughput capabilities of current state versus the new state. So here again, we're seeing in this view where we're moving parts in the new line. So easier to load because we're using a CNC bar feeder. So very easy to do that, and also 5-axis CNC machines, so changeover is very rapid. So we also have a data table in the AutoCAD environment that's providing feedback real-time on the line performance based on our criteria. So we can see that substantial energy savings are realized and a dramatic reduction in carbon footprint is also realized. So we get the data dashboard that tells us what we need to know. So we're going to see that in just a second. But again, 65% less energy, 1.3% better throughput on thousands of parts per day. That's a very good improvement. So if we look at the dashboard, this tells us all we need to know in regards to costs, throughputs, and manpower needs. Completely configurable. We can set this up any way we need it based on our KPIs. So again, very easy to work with. So to summarize, let's recap all the results that we have. So we're using 65% less energy with a sustainable friendly workflow. This reduces costs and has positive tax opportunities for us. In addition, we drive down the cost of the parts and produce more parts with less. As I had said, 1.3% doesn't sound much, but when you're putting out over 5,000 parts per day, that's a lot of parts. So we also have an impressive 73% reduction in energy costs per part which in turn reduces the production cost of each of these parts. This doesn't include the benefit of unneeded inventory, which we did not take into consideration in this simulation, but it could be measured as well to further build the case as we need to. And also 69% less carbon dioxide getting released into the environment, to the tune of nearly 500,000 pounds of carbon dioxide reduced each year. So that's something, again, that all of the people looking at sustainability are going to set up and take notice. And also, we can come to the conclusion with a sustainable and friendly workflow, the extrapolated benefit would pay for two of the new machines in the first year, and the outcome would be a well-supported, well-documented reason to change that finance people can't argue with. So we're not going to say, no, we'll just go with the machines we have right now, we'll maybe do this next year, and never get it done. So the last example we're going to talk about is a logistics study. So we have a customer that built a new plant, and they put in four lines in their new distribution center, and they're only using three of them currently. So they had an uptake, a spike in their demand, so they turned on the fourth line, and the outcome was not what they expected. In fact, they were having trouble determining where that problem was, and were considering adding more equipment or expanding space based on their past experiences. So we worked with the customer, and what had happened here is now the production throughput was going down and the costs were going up. So we started taking a look at what we could do about that. Rather than just going ahead, jumping off and building a building or changing the equipment, we said, let's go ahead and simulate this. So we looked at the as-is state and the new state running the fourth line in an as-is state. So we were able to determine from the data and the flow, the new line was feeding the system at too fast a rate, and it was disrupting flow of the existing system. So adding the fourth line did the exact opposite of what they expected. It slowed the system down, raising costs due to overtime having to be applied to keep up and be able to serve their customers in a timely manner. So from the data and by watching the simulation, we can get an idea where the problem lies and have a good idea on where to start. So the data told us that we have our new production line that we're just at or turning on here, and it causes congestion by increased number of pallets that are in route. And this also causes congestion by the inbound and outboard pallets. So according to the simulation, the proposed change gets rid of the congestion and allows the entire workflow to work efficiently within a standard 40-hour work week, right? So here's the proposed solution. So we're going to see these running side by side, and the change of the pallet feed into the warehouse is the suggestion. So this is a simple, low-cost change as compared to the other options of building expansion and equipment addition, which could run into millions of dollars. And also, in reality, probably wouldn't solve the issue. So as we run the current against the proposed, it becomes obvious where the problem is. Note how the products are backing up on the left side of the as-is simulation. The proposed change, which is simply a change of the conveyor speeds and a smarter feeding methodology into the system, alleviates the backup and it solves the problem. So by applying the entire solution, cost savings and design confidence can be assured in not only the installation phase, but also the validation that the design will meet production output goals with financial information to support it. So this gives us, in all cases, proven ideas with clear, actionable data that can be used over and over again for testing new scenarios for production. By applying the entire solution, cost savings and design confidence can be assured in not only the installation phase, but also validation that the design will meet production output goals with financial information to support it. So this gives us complete design confidence. So if you want to know more, you can meet us over at the Autodesk University booth, number 220. Our consulting staff is available to answer any further questions you may have, especially pertaining to your particular need. We have special show pricing for Pro Model at the AU event, and the coupon is available at the booth, and we can describe a little bit more about how that works. And then we also have reseller partners that are available to provide software and training for you, and many of these resellers are resellers that you all have been working with already. So I'd like to thank you for taking the time for attending this webinar, a seminar, or whatever you would like to call it, training class. I hope that you were able to glean enough information to garner more interest in looking at how these time saving, money saving, and work saving workflows could apply to your company.